Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lady Designer. We are back with another speed build video of our city zoo. And in this episode, we're going to be filling the gaps, actually. So we're not really going to build a new habitat or anything like that. We're definitely going to be filling some gaps. And we start with the African elephant habitat in front of it because we still have like this empty area. And I really want to have like this nice viewing going from the bridge towards the building itself. And we're also going to have like this small extension of the path on the right and the left side to have some benches and stuff. So just imagine that like you have this family and the kids are still inside and the mom and dad, it's like spring or summer and the mom and dad are just like wanting to chill a little bit in the sun. So they're going to sit down in those little areas and just enjoy there while the kids are looking at the African elephants in the indoor section. So on the sides of the path, we have this topiary hedge. Basically never really use those. I don't know, I feel like it does not always fit in certain areas, but I think for this occasion it definitely looks really nice to use those. And also to have something else instead of like the fencing we are using a lot in our whole city zoo. So I definitely do like that it's a little bit different. And this is basically like this more split off section of the rest of the zoo, so it's not bothering me or anything that it's looking a little bit different. And I also tried to create some more like an extra curb with like the limestone pieces to have it more matching like the bridge and the building itself. It's something I also never really do, but I felt like this is something I should just try out and see if that is going to help. Like that small little edge of detailing can make such a big difference. And the same goes for underneath like the elephant statues, just have like this little line of limestone just, I don't know, it just really makes everything look a match more with each other. So I do really like that I chose to just try that out, and I really do like how that is looking. Just a small little detail sometimes can bring you so much satisfaction, I guess. So in this area, I didn't want it to make it too dense. Like I have a lot of very dense areas around this whole zoo. But in this case, I really wanted to make sure like that the trees are not really that much in front of the building. So I only chose like, I think 4 ash trees to put in front of the building, but just making sure that you can still see the shape and the beauty of the building itself. So yeah, I really tried to pay attention to where I put down my trees and my bushes, not to make it like super high or anything. And the rest of the area is a little bit more with like oak trees and some more grass. Like I really wanted to make this more of an open space, and I do really like how that has turned out. On the edge of the water, I added just a few little rocks just to make it less plain looking. Also added a little bit more sunken trees and some more bushes and stuff to not make it super plain, because I don't know, at the water section you can have open sections but everything feels a little bit boring to me. But it's all just like little small little decorations to just finish off the whole area, I guess. And to give the whole section a little bit more color, I use deep purple colors to give it that more contrast and colorful feeling around the area as well. And I do think that you really could use sometimes a little bit of color. We could maybe use a little bit more even, but no, for now I will just keep it like this. The main focus in the end should be like the statues and the building itself, of course, leading towards the indoor section for the African elephants. Talking about the indoor section of the African elephants, as I mentioned in the previous episode where we were finishing that part of the building, I actually told you guys that I wasn't really happy with like the glass walls and stuff, and I really needed some ideas to see if I could make it better looking in the end. So yes, we're finally able to get back to this indoor section of the building, and I decided to make a few changes. So the glass panel is going to be changed into a steel fence, and that one is going to be lower. It's quite it's just about the right height for the African elephants, at least for the females. I didn't measure it for the male one. That one is maybe a slightly bigger, but yeah, the steel fence is actually just high enough above the elephants itself. And you should just imagine that on the side of the elephant itself, there should be an extra fence actually to make sure that the elephant is not able to put like its trunk or anything above the fencing or through the fencing. So, but I don't actually have that space to put that down on the indoor section. So in this case, I did not add an extra fence on that side, but I did add a fence on the inside, so where the guests are standing, to at least make sure like the kids that are not able to put their little fingers in, there would be obviously some signs here and there that you would not, that you're not allowed to put like your hands and your fingers through the fences itself, and yeah, something like that. But that is at least the idea behind it and why I put down fences as well on the inside at the section where the guests are standing. And also the brick flooring is going to be changed. So that is going to be replaced by a more wooden, warm color, wooden floor, because I just think that in the end looks a little bit better than the brick floor. I really wasn't happy with the brick floor. It really felt super cold and stuff. So I'm really happy that I took this time to switch this all off and to change the flooring as well. And also just adding like some wooden bins and benches in the end just really makes this all look a little bit more inviting to me. I hope you guys agree with that, but I do think it's the better decision I've made in this case for this elephant's house, definitely. So the entrance of the elephant's house, on the right side and on the left side, there were some sections that I was like, it's pretty useless actually here. So you know what? I'm actually just going to add a few more benches in and just going to cover them with the limestone itself. So yes, when the guests would be here in this section, they would actually be able to sit on these limestone benches. Well, they're hidden benches, obviously, but I don't think many guests will be using them. But yeah, you know, if you have like groups of people, it's not really the perfect area with the entrance, but they could definitely just gather around at the entrance of the elephant house before they move on, for example. So we did do a lot around the giraffe house as well in City Zoo, but unfortunately, I started my recording, but before that, I was actually checking my email. So for some reason, my Bandicam decided to just record my Outlook instead of Planet Zoo. So yeah, I actually lost quite a bit of footage there. But still, there is still some footage in, but there were a lot of areas around the giraffe habitat that I actually never really finished off, and I wasn't really sure how to do that. And especially around the more raised path, like going into the indoor section and going out of it, like depending from what side you're walking to. But I'm still not entirely happy, to be honest, with how that is looking. I might just change that again in a later stage, and I will do a short tour at the end of this video to show you guys around a little bit in this area and what I have done. And I will also show that particular area to you guys that I'm just not entirely happy with it. So I might just come back with that and just change it again and see if we can make that perfect and something I'm just really happy about. But I did do a lot of filling the gaps and stuff. Like nothing really spectacular on that side. Like there is this big area with the giraffe house with a lot of the small credit rocks. So I did use a lot of the small credit rocks to fill in some areas and to make it all connect more with the outside of the habitat, if that makes sense. So that is definitely something I have been working on, and just to purify everything a little bit more. And we move over to the lion's habitat, now the new lion's habitat I should say, because earlier we had the lion's habitat in the predators building we built very early in this series, I think. And later on, we moved them to the twin buildings. Both buildings are inspired by Rotterdam Zoo in the Netherlands, Blijdorp for all the people that are Dutch. And that one is going to be a little bit different because that one has like this more open area on the left side of the habitat. There is only going to be one view. Well, there is only one viewing gallery on the outside, and there is a viewing gallery on the inside. But there is still like this open space around that outdoor section, and I actually wanted to keep that open. So the gardening is a lot more neat, if you can say it that way. So it's way less of like just more dense and messy, but it really is more organized gardening, if you can call it that way. So I really try to stick with that, at least for around the whole habitat. And I still have to finish a part of that, but that I kept that open because I have no idea yet where that path is actually leading to. So I still have to figure out what we're going to do there exactly. And maybe we're going to extend the zoo maybe a little bit in the future, who knows? Because let's talk quickly about a new DLC. If you haven't seen it yet, in the newsletter of I think the end of February, they were saying about that they have been working on some stuff and they're excited to share more about what they have been working on throughout the month of March. So yes, obviously I've been saying it for months already, so it's not going to be a surprise for any one of you. But at the end of March, beginning of April, just like we just know from the roadmaps of Frontier Developments, there is going to be a new DLC. Mostly, well, I'm not entirely sure if that is still going to happen because of the popularity of Planet Zoo, but mostly we should be seeing like 4 DLCs in this new year still, and maybe after that they will stop making DLCs, but I'm actually not entirely sure if that is still going to be a thing. It might be that they will only have 2 or maybe 3, but okay, let's just say everything goes well and they still are making 4 DLCs. So then the first one is going to be March, April. Then the next one is probably going to be somewhere around June. And then the next, well, maybe June, July. And then the next one is going to be October, September, October. And then the last one would be right before Christmas in December. That is basically the roadmap Frontier is using for all their games. So they did that with Planet Coaster, they did that with Jurassic World Evolution, and now they do with Planet Zoo. The only thing that was different was that they only had 3 DLCs last year. And that could have been because of the pandemic that they may have been delayed or anything like that. But we don't know that for sure. So, but that could have been the reason why. But other than that, we just know that around the same time, you can just use Wikipedia and just check Planet Coaster and check Jurassic World Evolution when they had their DLCs and their updates. And then it's just 1+1 and then common sense what is going to happen for Planet Zoo as well. So, okay, end of the month, beginning of April, we're going to see a new DLC, and hopefully in like a week or two from now, we are hearing more about that new DLC. And knowing Frontier, they will probably first share some news about a free update, like they did with the Animal Talks, for example, with the previous one, and then like a few days later or like a week later, they were going to be announcing the new DLC that is going to drop, and that is basically how Frontier works. So it's not rocket science, there is going to be a new DLC. I am just really hoping that it's going to be something really awesome, and no offense for everyone that is looking forward for a European or a Asian DLC, but I just don't think... I don't think at all that a 4 or 5 habitat animals DLC is going to excite anyone anymore. I do hope that they're definitely going to listen this time and that there are going to be bigger packs. If only they're just adding some reskins in. I actually don't even mind if they are using certain animals and just change it to a different type of species. I honestly don't mind if that is going to mean that we're going to have different or more animals in a pack. But yeah, okay, that can be personal, like not everyone agrees with that. But in all honesty, I'm a little bit tired with the 4 to 5 animal DLCs at this point. So I do really hope that it's going to be one, a good fun DLC like aquariums or aviaries, something spectacular, something new that we haven't seen yet. Yeah, well, maybe they can do something with an Asia pack or a European pack, but I'm just afraid that it's going to be like similar to the Australia pack, South America pack, or the Arctic pack. So that is something I'm a little bit worried about. So that's why I'm not having too many high hopes at this point of what a new DLC will bring. But yeah, we just have to wait and see, I guess, what it is going to bring. The aquatic pack was surely something different, but still the amount of animals was a little bit disappointing, to say the least. So we just have to wait and see. I'm just curious how you guys think about that. So do let me know in the comment section down below if you have any opinion about that. And I'm sorry if I offended anyone that is looking forward towards an Asian pack or a European pack. I totally understand that some people are like, oh, I really want to have this or that Asian or European animal. But in the end of the day, like making the game more interesting, I doubt if that is going to help getting more people back into the game, because a lot of people are just now moving on or are going to play Prehistoric Kingdom, which is going into alpha stage at the 19th of March. So that is also going to be very exciting. And I do know that a lot of people are really excited for that game. It looks really great. It's like Planet Zoo, but then with prehistoric animals and dinosaurs. So it's definitely something you should like. I think the game looks very, very promising. It already has aviaries, by the way. Just saying. so yeah, it's definitely in a game that we're going to cover on the channel as well. But we're not going to drop Planet Zoo. But I just hope that Planet Zoo is seeing the danger here that a lot of people would also probably love to play some Prehistoric Kingdom for a change. So yeah, it could cause some issues for Planet Zoo development in the future, but who knows, maybe they know about the game. Obviously they know about the game. So yeah, I just hope that they're not going to miss out on any chances of making bigger and better packs now. But we have to wait and see. I mean, how many people complain about EA and The Sims, and we know how much they actually improved the game, right? So yeah, okay, enough sad about that. Without further talking, let's just jump into a tour to show you guys around a little bit of what I have done so far in City Zoo with filling up the gaps. All right, so here we go. I will try to keep the game on pause mode as much as possible because, well, this zoo is just getting bigger and it's definitely starting to lag. It's not like 30 FPS anymore. I have around 20 FPS at the moment. But yeah, this is the bridge that we already finished a while back, actually. I think I did that during a live stream. I'm not entirely sure anymore. But yeah, this is the elephants indoor section. So the outdoor section is in the backside. That we uploaded that one on in a previous episode, obviously. And the guests are only able to walk here because with the outdoor section is going to be visible only from the Jeep Safari that we are building. So we have this seating area right over here, as I mentioned, like for parents just to sit down and chill while their children are inside enjoying the lovely elephants. I think it's definitely looking really cute from here, like not hiding away the building too much with a lot of foliage and trees, but just so you can still see the beautiful shape of this building itself. Let me just quickly show indoors. So as I said, these are seating areas. The guests can actually really use that in the game. And then we move over to these platforms. So here I also use the animals' talking point, which is actually kind of cool. I did delete a few of the hay beddings, so we are able to actually throw in food into the habitat. So that is really cool. And other than that, well, the guests can just sit here and enjoy the elephants when they are inside. You can have a little peek into the indoor habitat right over here through the glass, which is actually really, really nice. And as I said, like this one is exactly the height or almost a height of a female elephant, at least. I don't know about the male one. There is the male one, but I haven't seen that one inside at the moment to measure it out. But yeah, and this side is just exactly the same, and having a nice glimpse into the outdoor habitat right over here as well. And of course some education on this side. So yeah, I am actually really happy with how it turned out right now, comparison to what we had. I think it definitely looks is an improvement, at least like removing the bricks and stuff. I think that definitely looks a lot better. So let's move on to this section right over here. On the left side, we have the lion's habitat. And as I said, this is the only area that is not being finished yet, because I'm not entirely sure yet how this will all be connected. So that is why we did not finish that one yet. And on the right side, we have the giraffe house. So let's move over to that section first. So that is going up right over here. So you have a viewing gallery into the habitat. And yeah, I basically just filled this up a little bit. But as I said, like the outside of these path, I'm just not entirely happy with it yet. I don't know what it is, but I need to fix that. As you can tell, we right over here have an animal talking point. So also in this occasion, the educator can throw in food, which is actually quite cool. Yeah, throwing food, because the giraffes are not able to walk here. So they will keep their distance from the guests in this way. But you do have zoos where you are actually able to feed the giraffes. So that would actually also be a cool idea if you would be able to feed the giraffes in this case. But yeah, on the outside right over here, just adding some foliage and stuff And there's a glass walls here and there because I just wanted to make sure that there were separate water sections, but that will be completely gone when we are going to finish this whole zoo. So that's only temporarily. Moving through the indoor section right over here, didn't change much right over here. We have the same thing on this side. It looks okay, but I don't know. It might be just like this ugly concrete thing under the path that I just don't really like. And that bothers me. So I'm not entirely happy. But I did add like all this foliage right over here, just really filling it all up on this side as well. And then just trying to make this look nice. But also this is not entirely what I wanted. But I just don't have that much space, which is actually quite annoying. We still have a work in progress here with the park. So that one is still not finished. Like, I didn't do anything on this side at all, to be honest. So there's still a lot of work to do. But doing this in phases, like filling the gaps and stuff, at least make sure that you're not having to do this all when you are finished in the end. So this is also a great example. This one is also not finished yet on this side. This is not finished yet. But on the other side, we have been working. As I said, this is more like the more neat gardening idea. We have the lion's habitat on that side. And then right over here, I just continued with the same pattern all over again. And I do think that's really nice. And I do think that this is far enough so the guests will not be looking into the lion habitat right over here. So I do think that is working in this case. I do hope so, at least. I have not been checking it too much. But yeah, they obviously have like this viewing gallery inside the habitat over here. Oh, we have more adult lions, I see. I think that is something I need to work on and finish really quickly. But yeah, I didn't change anything right over here. But this is the only outside viewing gallery into the habitat for the West African lions. This section, I did change a little bit. Let's go to the other side again, right over here. So in the beginning, this was all open. So I had like this whole green thing here with grass, and I had this whole green grass flat area as well. But I split it basically up into two sections. So one still a grassy land section and as well over here, and then half of it is going to be is filled with like a lot of bushes and trees and stuff, really making it dense, because this is definitely this style we already have in our city zoo. So I do think that it makes total sense, but also makes it like a little bit more private in certain areas. Like as well as here, we have the warthog and the aardvark habitat on the other side. So it really works well. We will get there in a second. So as you can see, this is all stuff that I still have to work on. We have the mandrill habitat on this particular section. So this is something we're going to work on very soon, obviously, to also fill this up with a nice garden and more of a park feeling. But yeah, I really wanted to keep this open here so you don't have to fill up everything with trees and shrubs. I think this definitely just also works keeping this more open and just giving you a nice viewing towards the buildings as well. I do really like that. And so if we continue right over here, as I said, we have the aardvark and the warthogs on this side. And I actually already told you guys when I was working on that episode that this was all open and I was like, that is just not going to work. It didn't feel right at all. So now having this more filled up with like a little bit of fencing, what we used a lot in the zoo. And also I added some trees right over here. I think I removed them at some point when I was building. But just having this more hidden away, you can't really see it. If you're standing here, you don't see anything from what is behind here. And that is something that I feel like really fits at least the zoos that I grew up in, like Rotterdam Zoo Blijdorp. Definitely something that you can't really see what is on the other side. And that is something I have in my mind when I build these kind of things. But yeah, so if we just move on to here, then you see this building appear with the small little animals, the aardvarks on the right side and the warthogs on the left side, adding some bins and some benches over here. And they have their more privacy section right now. And I do really, really like that. So right over here, we move on, then you move into the twin buildings with the Jeep Safari entrance right over here. and a restaurant on this side right over there. And then we have the indoor, indoor habitat for the West African lion on that side as well. So I didn't do anything else. We already did this earlier with some yellow flowers. I'm not really sure if you can call it flowers. I think they're flowers. And trees and bushes to have some nice garden in front of this whole thing. But having everything open to also see those signs, I think that definitely works really well. But behind this building, there's also still a lot of stuff we have to do in the end. But yeah, I think it definitely comes along very nicely. Let me just show you from the top right over here. So this is definitely the section that we still have to work on together with like the entrance and stuff of the Jeep Safari. So that is definitely going to be in one episode. We still have a lot of stuff to do right over here. We have the kangaroo habitat and we're going to have a dingo habitat on this side as well, with a restaurant and some toilets probably over here as well. I think that makes sense if we have a restaurant right over here and the restaurant right over here. And we also have a restaurant right in here. So I think that makes total sense to have some toilets and some food and drinks in this section as well. But we also have some food and drinks right over here, by the way. But yeah, other than that, there is not that much left to do in this section. I can still have an extension right over here, actually. So who knows, maybe with the new DLC right over here, or maybe right over here, because we also have a path right over here still. But I also want to have like a cheetah and stuff, like the Jeep Safari will go to the back side right over here. So maybe that is what we're going to use it for. So a lot of things, work in progress and stuff. But we are definitely getting there. But also right over here in front of the reptile house, we still need to work a lot on. And we still have like the Asian area that is also still not finished yet. So there is still a lot of work to do. But just to give you guys an idea, so far, this is definitely coming along really, really nicely. I'm very happy with the progress of City Zoo. It's kind of pity that the frames are going down right now, but it's still not totally bad. Like, it's not the worst that I've ever seen. So we still have time and space and the memory left to continue with this zoo. But yeah, I'm really, really happy with definitely how this all has turned out, with filling in the gaps and the entrance, of course, of the African elephant indoor section. I'm really happy with the end result of this, with like the cute little statues and stuff. I think it looks great. But the question is, how do you guys feel about the progress we did so far in City Zoo? Do let me know in the comment section down below, of course. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And you may want to consider to become a FAFEM member with the join button of YouTube. And you may also get some early access to some Planet Zoo and later on some Prehistoric Kingdom videos. Or become a patron via Patreon with the link down in the description with some early access pictures. And you can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and all those other social media pages. All those links are down in the description below. And yeah, I really just want to thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you guys enjoyed this short little tour we did. And yeah, I really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye, guys!